Hey guys, I just updated my Galaxy S3 GT-I9300 to the latest Android 4.3, and I have it here. And today I'm gonna show you what is new in this update and as well the changes in this update. So first I'm gonna show you the version that I'm in. Here we go, Android 4.3 Jelly Bean, and it's running on build number XXUG ML3 latest Malaysia. So firstly, we're going to start off by I'm going to tell you the new features, which is now this phone can support the Galaxy Gear smartwatch. But first, in order for you to support it, you need to download the app from the Samsung App Store. Here it is, for free, and you just install it and you should be able to use it. Since I don't have the Galaxy Gear with me, I cannot demonstrate to you now, so sorry. Moving on now, we have some new Samsung apps in this update as well. We got new camera. I mean the new Google Drive. This wasn't included. Now it's inside, and we have new calculator as well. It's full screen now. Let's see what we have here. We have a new gallery as well now. We're using the S4 gallery now. It's here. And let's see, we're using. There's a group play app here, and it's a new one. You have to install it. I'm not gonna do that for now. So, let's see what we got. We have the new S voice as well. This one is using the S voice. Yep, and let's see. We have a new video player now, using the S4 video player as well. That's all we get. Based on widgets, we don't get that much new widgets. We only get none at all. All is the old ones. It's sad. And we're still using, you notice we're still using the old widget here. Which is not nice. I prefer the S4 widget, but I don't know why it's using this. Okay, moving on now, we're talking about the notifications. So now you can see a transparent notification bar, which is nice. I don't like the black one, but this is better. And now when you pull down with one finger, of course you get notifications. And now pull down with two fingers, you get the list of toggles here. This is new. And you got some brand new toggles. You got Wi-Fi, hotspot, S-beam, NFC. Driving mode has been replaced with hands-free mode. And screen mirroring, these are all new toggles. It's kind of nice. You can edit them any way you want to be displayed later, so that's nice as well. And we have a new auto brightness adjustment. Now we have auto, we can plus 5 or you can minus if you want, or you can just leave it in the middle, which is the best. So yeah, so that's the new things. Now let's go to settings. This is gonna be a new one for all new settings UI. It's totally different now. It's using the tab UI you see on the S4. So now you don't have to go scrolling down to find about device. You just tap more and you're there. So let's see what we have here. And speaking of display, we have a new screen mode. Now we have adapt display, which is automatic. It senses light and see which is the best displays it will select for you. Now we have professional photo, also it's a new one. Which is, I don't find it different, standard. Bit of difference in color. Standard's the best, I think. And let's see, the daydream mode. This is when your phone is charging or you're off the screen, it kicks in and it will display colors, or if you press Google Photos, it'll display photos while it's charging. So that's kind of nice. Let's see what we got. We have a new voice control here. You on it. Incoming calls means you can answer, you just say answer or reject when incoming calls. Alarm, you can stop alarm when it's ringing. Camera, you can say capture, shoot, smile. And music, you can go to next, previous, play pause. So that is kind of nice, you can use your voice. And now you're gonna see the new keyboard. So you can see here the keyboard is a bit different. It's a bit different here. It's not that the wordings a bit different this time. I think it's sharper a bit. And now I'm gonna move on to the new camera feature we got. So let's take a look. Sadly, didn't change a thing in the interface, so that's a bummer. But we have a new mode here, shooting mode. A new mode called sound and shot. From the S4, we only get one mode from the S4. That's sad. And when once this takes a photo, when you are this will take a photo and then it will record a sound. So let's test it out. Testing 1, 2, 3. And there, that's how you do it. Just record a sound, and once you open the photo, it'll play the sound. So that's quite nice. And next up, let's take a look at the new internet browser we got here. It's like the S4 type, but let's see the tabs. And it's not using the Windows tab, it's using the old tab system here. Not you get on the S4, the new window type of tab. It's not good. Let's see what we got. And yes, we have a new feature here that you would like. Which is in the app manager. Finally, you can move your apps to your SD card, which is finally here. And now you don't have to worry about space. So let's say you wanna move, let's say Minecraft. There we go, we can move to SD card. There's a button here, you can move it. I'm not gonna do that now. So finally, this is available. And now I'm gonna talk about the lock screen. So let's take a look. Finally, we have multiple widgets, which means we can add widgets to our lock screen. And we also have the new ripple effect. It's a different type now. And we can add a custom message as well over here. It's like the S4, it's like Live Companion, that message. So now we can add, like, let's say testing. Sorry, testing, save. Once we lock the device and unlock. Sorry, there we go, testing. Well, that's it for this video, and I hope that you know the new things in this update. And if there's anything I missed out, go ahead and leave the comments. And overall, this update is quite okay, but I will still have to do some testing for a few days for battery life. And I'll do a review on the phone about the games, gaming performance, and as well as other stuff like firmware stability report. That's it. So hope you guys enjoy this video. And I will hope to see you all in the next video.